Staples. I call him a staple in the Maple because he's at every hip hop show. He is a true Toronto supporter. Whether, you know, it's people coming from out of town to Toronto, and especially the Toronto artists themselves. He goes by the name of the one and only Mindbender.
Yo, thanks, Mel. Happy to be here. It's an honor and a pleasure.
How you doing?
I feel like
we haven't chopped it up in so long.
Yes, I disappeared for a minute because not only my other careers and the other...
Which we'll get into.
We'll get into, yeah. I wear many Kangols. But, yeah. But I also really wanted to focus on this album because... As you said, I love to support everyone and everything, but I've gone to the... I'm 41 years old, and like...
You're a baby.
I know. I feel young, and I'm still doing my dreams, but I've seen, you know, Prodigy and Fife Dog and even, like, Pumpkinhead. Like, I've known some hip-hop heads passing, and I'm like, honestly, like, I love Toronto, but I still don't feel like I've gotten everything that I could get from the city, and I haven't shown everybody everything that I can do and the depth of my rhyme skill and who I really am. So I made this album, and this one is swinging for the stars. This one is, I think, the best thing I've ever made in my life so far.
Okay.
This huge double album. It's massive. It's inspired by Drake, Kanye, Rascast, like Pharrell Monch, Nas, Jay, like every, like, huge MCs with huge ideas and huge dreams. And I have my producer with me, my homie Peppermint.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, here I am. Peppermint, aka
You are there.
Jordan Randall. That's my name. Yes.
It's all right. You don't have to give the government names. Peppermint is good.
My social insurance number.
No. Before you leave the show, your whole bank account cleaned out one time. Well, how did this collaboration happen?
The initial stages are kind of foggy, actually, but we started this whole journey, like, I guess at the start of the year, like maybe February or something.
Yeah.
Like, we'd known each other before, but we knew that we both had talents in these different departments. So I think the idea just came up at the beginning of the year that let's just collaborate.
Mm-hmm.
So we did our first track. We recorded at a guy called Ruben Matarjan's studio. And then he had a lot of projects, so we couldn't do it there. So then we kind of just had to find our own means of recording it. And it started off as, like, we wanted to just do, like, maybe a 4-track EP.
Yeah.
And then it just kept growing. It was like...
kept going.
We had 4 tracks, then we had, like, 8 tracks. And then...
And so on. And they told 2 friends. And they told 2 friends.
Yes.
Okay.
It exponentially grew, and then we ended up with a double album that its running time is, like, 2 hours. So
it's
pretty big.
It's huge, Edgar. Well, we were really... I'll let you speak.
All right. I was just going to say that, you know, your sound, you're, like you said, you're a true hip-hop fan. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you're influenced by all these different hip-hop artists. And your sound is so unique. And it's borders on eccentric, borders on eclectic almost.
Mm-hmm.
How do those marry? Like, how did you guys come together? And how were you, Peppermint, able to stay true to what Mindbender's essence is?
I'd like to say where the original connection was. Like, he's also a videographer. He's also a Renaissance man like myself, but with many talents. And I'm not going to jump the gun too much, but we were nominated for a British Porn Award this year.
Okay, you're getting ahead of me.
I don't want to get ahead too much, but that is actually where it connects, because I was on Pornhub and there's an extra.
Okay, we have to back up a little bit.
It's so sorry, but this is the actual core of where it connects. Because I was on there just seeing something that was on there, and I was like, he had taken some extra footage from the documentary that we had done,
right?
And he put a beat to it, and I was like, I was listening to this, and I was like, yo, this beat is banging, and I was like, yo, dog, I never saw that clip you did, because our documentary got nominated, and then the extra stuff just had some fresh beats behind it, and I was like, yo, who made these beats? And he was like, I did. And I was like, yo, you make beats too?
I didn't actually make those beats, though.
Those
beats were from a dubstep producer in England called Morg, who's a good friend of mine.
Oh, yeah. I thought you made those.
I think the conversation started from that, and then I was like, but I make beats too.
Yeah.
And then...
Oh.
So that's the actual...
Clarity comes out in
Super 515. Clarity. Yeah. But the thing is, his vision, though, what he did to it, and it's still up on that website, and I was just like, yo, if you have this kind of creative idea, and you're like into beats like this, next level stuff, and just creative art, like, I am too. And so then we started the original song we wanted to do was Kill the Future. That's that's the first song we started with, and now it's a massive double album that's really swinging for the stars. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So you kind of segued into your other career there. So just so people don't get too lost, My People's Mindbender has an alias. So he's also known as Malcolm Lovejoy.
I do that.
And you're just taking over the adult entertainment industry.
I'm doing what I can to spread love and healthy sexuality and positivity and mature communication.
Right.
And also bring honesty in sexuality to hip hop, because there's been so much fabricated and lies and just rappers saying they're one thing and then going home to be married wives. Like, peace to Ja Rule, but Ja Rule spent so many years on the holla holla tip and like, but then he went home to a married wife and kids, which is cool. But like, you're like fronting like you're a player. But like, there's so many MCs that pretended like they were these super sexy rock stars and stuff, and they really weren't those people. And I'm like, yo, just be yourself. Like, not every rapper has to have a sexual edge. Like, you know, Q-Tip is not super sexual, and he's a good looking dude, but like, he's like, yo, I'm a creative artist. Just be yourself. So I just got to a point where I'm like, yo, hip hop is limiting me. I'm a very sexual person, and just rhyming about sex isn't even enough anymore. So I got into adult.
You gotta live that real real.
I gotta live the real real. You know, in a way, I'm the cool Keith of Canada.
That is so on point, because when people, when I describe your music to people, that's what I say.
Yes.
You're the cool Keith. Like, if you like cool Keith, you'll definitely love Mindbender.
That's so real. And I mean, mad love and respect and peace. Props to Cool Keith forever. But Cool Keith never actually filmed porn. Like, he just very much supported it and very much was a aficionado of it, which I am too. But there's only been like 10 or 11 MCs in rap history that have actually filmed porn and rhymed. And I am now in that group. I'm the only I think there's only two in Canada. There's a dude in Montreal named Mike Life. Shout him out. But yeah, he also rhymes in French. But I'm the only English-speaking hip-hop in Canada that's making porn officially. And I'm the only one who's won an award for it anyway.
Yes.
So I'm making...
You know what? Now that it's, you know, been a few years and it's settled in and everybody knows, you know, your alter ego.
Yeah.
It's not a secret, and you've never kept it a secret, so I really respect you for that. You've always been very open about what you do, and you and I have had like side conversations because there's stuff that I didn't understand, and and like you and I were actually building and chopping it up, which I appreciate that openness. But now that, you know, it's been out there for a while, like, how is the general hip hop community receiving it, or how do they receive it, or does it even matter anymore?
It always matters, and it's a lifelong journey. There's constant education. There's always new levels. I need to learn new things, and there's always things happening in hip hop that make me realize, like, yo, this is one of the last unexplored areas of hip hop, talking about sexuality in an honest way. Whether it's like Jay-Z spent 20 years just, you know, big pimpin', hey poppy, just the player, you know, hottest chick in the game. But now he's a married man with kids. Same with Kanye. They're married with kids. And like, Kanye and Drake have this issue with Drake sleeping with Kim Kardashian. I believe it happened. I'm saying on the record, I believe it happened. Yeah, but like, either way, Kanye's worried about it. And there's issues of sexuality. Fabulous is being prosecuted for assaulting Emily B. Like, there's real sexual issues. Like, there's guys that have problems.
Well, yeah, that's a control.
But, you know, I don't even mean to judge. I'm just saying, like, in hip hop, there's dudes that have stuff that they gotta work out. Mm-hmm. And even women too. Yo, Cardi B and Nicki are wilding out right now. And they're wilding.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, and there's threatening kids and stuff like that. Yeah. So it's like getting real ugly. And this is part of the reason why the album is called New Colors, New Dimensions, and New Values. Like, I really want hip hop to look at its values, because, you know, it's a crazy, wild, interesting, weird time in the world.
It is a very weird time. And I do appreciate, you know, like I said, you being very open, because historically, the Black community has always been very closed when it comes to sexuality, mental health issues, and that sort of thing. So I appreciate you at least you know, living your best life.
Yeah, I'm in my dreams.
And I know there are a number of people who are living vicariously through you.
Oh, thank you. Yo, I thank you all, and I appreciate you all. Shout me out, because I don't hear that much support. Like, I don't get that much hate. If I was a woman, I'd be hated on more, and I'm really trying to fight the slut shaming, which is why we did a song called Cancel the Show on the album. Mm-hmm. We address a lot of really big issues. We talk about the connection between America and Africa, and there's so many things we go into. I mean, I love the song that we made about Toronto. We made a very important Toronto anthem.
Why don't you let us know? Yeah, let us know about that one.
Yeah,
talk about it a bit.
The video, like Jordan shot some of the video, but do you want to talk about it?
Sure. Yeah. So Welcome to Cybertron started, I believe, like conceptually well before the music came in. But my mentor, as everyone knows, he's like, you know, the hip hop mayor of Toronto. He's a historian. He's a hip hop historian. So he knows everything that's happened about the city. I mean, on a hip hop level and like on a political level too. So
very much so. Yeah.
Yeah. So the song really, I think, encapsulates a lot of that. It's, you know, musically, I think it's one of our accessible songs, as we were saying. It's like, it's a single. I mean, we try to get pretty weird on this album musically and stuff, and just try and
push boundaries.
Not do the same thing.
Yeah, we try to do stuff that we didn't hear already, and so like Cybertron has, you know, elements of songs that we have heard before, but we kind of spun it in our own way. So it's like, it's our sort of weird, like, upside down Toronto pop anthem.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I like that. All right. So while DJ Channel 9 gets something a little bit ready, he's queuing that up. Can you introduce it? Because I know we'll get into more of the adult entertainment stuff after.
That's cool.
Because when I said Mindbenders on the show, that's what people hit me up with. Mel, ask him about the porn.
Word. Okay. We'll go into it after.
Calm down, Toronto. We'll get to it. You know, I'm about the music first.
Yeah, for real. Like, are y'all lovemakers or what? Yo, we got to do some foreplay first. You
exactly.
Know? This is the foreplay.
Man, yeah, these kids out here just trying to rush to the...
Yo, for real.
Take your time.
For real, slow down. First base.
Slow down.
You know,
That's what I'm saying.
You know, glass of wine. Roll a split.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to get into the tune. The name of the song is... Welcome to Cybertron. And that's off of Mindbender's new album. Call me up. You're feeling it. Let me know how you feel. 416-736-5656. If you have questions for Mindbender, because I know y'all do.
Yo.
Y'all have been hitting me up all day.
I'm an open heart. I'm an open book. I got nothing to hide. Just, it's pure love and truth. So ask me anything.
416-736-5656. Mindbender's in the booth with Peppermint. Keep it locked.
Welcome to the city of the future and new millennium of music. Mindbender's your guide, aka all I see in tower, supreme MC genius sound birth needed around earth. Toronto's a beautiful woman, but she's cold with rest and screw face. Rent chokes the poverty stricken, nearly homeless, collecting loose change. Money hungry, lovely, struggling, working class, herded trap, nervous rats, race chasing extra maze, but never earn a chance. Trying to keep up with the Joneses, knowing it'll fail, lump junkhead failing a drug test. But this ain't Riverdale, it's Springfield, but John Tory's only half as corrupt as Mia Joe Quimby. Mel Aspin, a rock for the trash compared to David Miller. Know your Toronto history. The T.O.D. The mega city, the screwface capital, the 416. The T.O.D. The mega city, the screwface capital, the 416. Toronto used to be North America's best kept secret. Now from the States to Beijing to Sweden, they play Drake and Weekend every day and weekend. They hated it so, now they get cloned XO in October's very own. Outcasts like me smoke away the pain of less fame. I'm not sober, very stoned. Pot smoker long before Trudeau approved show. My dopeness was yours to discover in Ontario. Before Oliver's jewelry said, oh yeah, to buying silver wearing gold. Before Russell Peters was problematic. Before Ed the Sock was hysterical. Know your Toronto history. Our city is incomparable. The T.O.D. The mega city. The screwface capital. The 416. The T.O.D. The mega city. The screwface capital. The 416. The T.O.D. The mega city. The screwface capital. The 416. The T.O.D. The mega city. The screwface capital. The 416. Toronto sure loves to promote its multicultural flair, but nothing compares to the hope we'll know when we vote in a person to call it for mayor. Listen respect for that mark. Mark Saunders diminished because he blamed the Church Street community for the gay killer that stalked in the village. Obnoxious officials of freedom and dreams can be gone in a minute. From coppers convicted or modern religion, ignorant laws, innocent pawns too often lost in the system. Incompetent villains try to stop all the hip-hop business progress we're building. In Toronto, superstar success can feel like a constant impossible mission. This is Keaton talking about trap and scissor, but then elementals are rap essentials. Well, I hope the circle reassembles like Mac Avengers and Ghetto Concept gets back together. And yeah, the weather was whatever for like 3 or 4 months. So I hibernate with 9 dimes and lick them up to sleep, then I smoke blunts. Don't front when you see King Mind Bender take it back to the future of the old soul funk. Classic parties with no fights and no guns. There's tons of clothes flung. Plus gas get out when it warms up. Yeah, done, no, it don't stop, yo, son. Our city is incomparable paradise. If you can't show love, don't come.
Make their mark.
Studio B. Studio B.
Yes, yes, I can't make you love me. But I'll try.
Yo, yes. Super, super secret little jewel I gotta drop to you.
Okay.
Mindbender does have a song prepared with Socrates in the stack.
Get out!
But it's not recorded yet.
Okay.
But it is. It is written and it is ready and it will be dropped in the future.
Okay, dope.
I didn't talk about that, but that's real.
You know how much I love Socrates.
I love Socrates to death.
Shouts out to my GT Massive on the outside too while I'm at it.
And Rich Kid too.
But yes, that is, you just heard some brand new Mindbender. What's the name of the track again?
That's Welcome to Cybertron.
Welcome to Cybertron. And he has the sound effects of Optimus Prime in the song. So.
Yes,
featuring Optimus Prime. Yeah.
Featuring Optimus Prime and Claire Wetmore singing on the hook. Claire,
okay. Yeah.
Big up to her because that's not my beautiful voice singing.
All right. Now, like I was saying before we went to the track, a lot of people hit me up, ask me about the porn. But what I wanted to ask you is, how has, you know, being on camera and being open that way, how has that made you, or how do you feel that's made you a stronger artist on the mic, whether it's through content, through delivery, through whatever? How do you think that has enhanced what you do as an artist, period?
I'm so glad you asked that. It's made literally I can honestly say every single rhyme and line that I write is genuinely authentic.
Like, right.
I live such a beautiful sexual reality that when I'm rhyming about orgies or threesomes, I'm not fabricating anything.
Yes.
Like, it's like, that's not even the core of everything, because it's 100% romance and sexuality. So sometimes I'm in a wild sexual situation. Sometimes, like yesterday with my beautiful partner, Vivian Tyler, shout out to the few lovely women in Toronto that love to make porn with me. I love to everyone that has the dream, but very few people show up and come into the Gladiators arena and make it happen. So blessings to all the porn watchers and especially the porn makers. But I'm saying all that to say, like, for the people that show up, we make beautiful romantic moments together, and we make videos that can live for eternity and show people good, healthy, sexual, adult passion and intimacy and connection, which is the core of so many beautiful songs and families and wars and just the good things in life. So it makes my artistry and me as an artist 100% authentic and really, I know my boundaries of who I am and who I'm not gonna pretend.
Right.
So I just love it. Like, I'm like, I don't have to front. It's good. I can just be honest about what I love, and I'm just a naked open book at all times.
Okay, well, I'm gonna be honest with you. I can't even watch anything right now.
Yeah, that's so good.
It's just I know I can't unsee some things, and I just love you the way that you are.
Yes.
I just don't want to change anything.
That's great. That's
we're great. Good. We're good right now. So I'm gonna leave it right there.
I'm gonna leave it right there. Yes, and I would never force anybody. Like, I know, I feel like I believe that sexuality is the thing that is the core to everyone's identity, and it's the deeper subject, even more sensitive than religion and politics. So I don't expect people to watch my porn just because I do porn. I'm like, yo, you have a different relationship to porn than I do. And like, just as long as you understand that it's legal, I'm not there's no shotguns involved, I'm not roofying anybody, this is all I'm not twisting no girls' arms. These are all consensual adults having legal, happy, safe, honest sex.
Passionate,
beautiful sex. The sex here is way more safe than the sex that happens in all the bars and clubs and all the people doing things on Friday and Saturday night. Those people are less tested and less respectful and communicative. So I am, you know.
Well, I'm 100% on board with you discussing Black sexuality because, like I said, traditionally, our community just is closed. And because of that, there's so many issues that we go through. And you don't see a lot of it surface until you go into adulthood, you know, until you see your friends become parents or you see your friends challenged in certain ways. And it all leads to, you know, being repressed in some way.
Yeah.
And we don't discuss it. So I do applaud you on that front because I think that's very, very important.
Thank you so much. And it's really like, I want to break the cycles from my father. My father was abusive and my father did some horrible things that I'm just like, yo, like, he got deported. He's in Jamaica right now. Like, like, there's so many of us that have similar family, broken families or, you know, remarried or blended families or all this, you know, baby mamas and fathers and brothers and all this stuff, just chaos of life. But you know, we all still gotta love and protect and care for each other and heal each other while we try to break the cycles of our parents and grandparents and all their problems. So, but speaking of love though, we gotta give a shout out. I'm not gonna say her name, but the beautiful, angelic, lovely woman that was on our cover.
And the cover alone is worth seeing.
The
album itself is worth taking a listen to. I want you to let them know one more time what the name of the album is.
The album is called Journey into Sound. New colors, new dimensions.
New dimensions, new values.
New values. Yeah. But I like, Jordan, if there's anything else you want to say, because he did so much work on it. Like, the sound of it, we really wanted to make a sound, something that sounds different from everything in hip hop right now. Everything that was really the core of the project. And without this guy, it wouldn't happen. So.
Okay. Well, you know what? We'll get a little bit more into it after the break.
Okay.
We do got to take a quick break. Shouts out to my people's Mindbender and Peppermint in the studio. Shouts out to everyone on the Instagram Live. And shouts out to everyone who was ringing on the phone while I was on the air, so you know I couldn't answer. But call back 416-736-5656. We're going to take a quick commercial break and be back with Mindbender. And we got some new music courtesy of my people's DJ Channel 9. So keep it locked right here, Vibe 105.
Studio B with Mel Boogie and DJ Channel 9. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger Flame here in sicko mode. They're here on Vibe 105. The list is on Vibe 105. Are you on the list? Then let's go.
Are you a dedicated barber looking for steady work? Have we got the home for you? Uppercut Barbers is looking for professional barbers. Contact Lincoln at 416-302-0359 or stop by Uppercut Salon, 4331 List in Brampton. Uppercut Barbers, the place for barbers. Don's Caribbean Dirk Restaurant, 3078 Mayfield Road, Unit 17, Brampton. Corner of Mayfield and here, Ontario. Authentic Caribbean cuisine, home of the international famous Rasta Pasta. Don's Caribbean Dirk Restaurant, Brampton. 905-970-1717. Treat yourself better. You deserve it. Akili Med Spa is the place to be for all your basic skincare needs. Limited time special on laser hair removal starting at $139 for 6 sessions, including underarms or Brazilian. Book an appointment now. Call 647-302-8529. Spicy Island Jerk, 135 Main Street North, Unit 2, located in the heart of downtown Brampton, home of the Caribbean fusion cuisine. Seafood dishes on pre-order. Brampton's only home of jerk chicken wrap. Spicy Island Jerk, 905-455-5010. Are you looking to buy or sell a home? For realtors you can trust, call Calvin or Samantha at Century 21, 1-800-704-7727. Let us help you find your next home. That's Calvin or Samantha, Century 21, 1-800-704-7727. Patty World, located at 86 Guided Court, Unit D, the only home of the specialty Jamaican-style patties. Also, fall special box of cold beef patties for $9.99. 416-749-6111. Patty World, a patty taste of Jamaica.
For more info, visit vibe105to.com.
4 million things touch the car? Got it all dirty? Come to Steel's 400 Car Wash. Fast, convenient, and voted number one best wash value. 3360 Steel's Avenue West. It's time to shine with our tender touch wash process. Keep it clean. Steel's 400 Car Wash.
At Cycle & Tone, we understand working out can be a drag. Gym memberships are hard to commit to, and doing anything fitness-related feels like a chore. That's why we've decided to change the way you feel about getting fit by combining indoor cycling with the hottest dancehall soca, reggae, and more. Your first class is only $5. Join us today at one of 4 studios in Brampton, Pickering, Scarborough, and North York. It doesn't even feel like you're working out. To book, visit cycleandtone.com. Follow us on social media at Cycle & Tone.
Thanks to you, my daddy got home safely from his day at work.
Thanks to you, my daughter got home safely from her girlfriend's party on the weekend.
Thanks to you, my brother and I go to and from practice every week.
Most of us do our part to keep our roads safe by driving sober. We plan ahead, designate a driver, take taxis or transit, stay over, or call home. Thank you for driving sober. A message from Arrive Alive, Drive Sober, and CAA. To find out more, visit arrivealive.org.
In a sea of people, it's easy to get lost amongst all the stories we have to tell. Yet a new voice is being heard, one that offers real insight and inspires greatness. Our goal is to make a statement. It's not about any one race, religion, or culture. It's about uplifting and empowering one another, celebrating our heritage, cultures, and spirit for positive change. Community-focused, we are the Toronto Caribbean Newspaper. Reach us at 647-722-6298 or torontocaribbean.com.
You're taking in Studio B on Toronto's best urban music, Vibe 105.
Yes, yes, and we're back with my people's Mind Bender in the studio.
Yeah.
Yes, and special guest Peppermint, producer, videographer, all over Renaissance man.
And my fingers in many pies.
Yes,
for
yes.
A movie bomb.
Yes, yes. All right, so Mindbender, why don't you let them know once again where the album can be found and the name?
So the album is called Journey into Sound, and it's available right now on YouTube exclusively. We kind of wanted to kind of give a bit of a tease by just putting the album in its entirety on YouTube. But it's going to be out in a couple weeks on all major streaming platforms, so Spotify, Tidal, Deezer, iTunes, Apple Music, Google Music, whatever other ones there are.
We really wanted to bring back the singular listening experience the best we can. Like, you know, it will be available in pieces soon, but, you know, just when you used to take in an album and the whole thing was a masterpiece, like Ninjas for Life, or, you know, It Takes a Nation of Millions, Resurrection, Reasonable Doubt, things like that. Just, you know, Wu-Tang Forever, you know? Things. Okay. So, I mean, time will tell what this album stands up to for the classics, but I genuinely, sincerely believe that this is one of the greatest Canadian hip-hop albums ever made. Yes. Definitely in 2018, and I think time will be very, very generous to us as the years go on, because this is some timeless content, and there's some stuff about Stolen from Africa and reparations in Jamaica and just timeless hip hop issues. Shout outs to Kool Herc and just love, sex, truth, power, and Toronto.
All of the above. All right, so social media handles. Where can people follow you and stalk you online?
Stalk me all day. I'm open book. I'm on Twitter all the time. Mindbender Mind on Twitter or Malcolm Lovejoy on Twitter. I'm also on Instagram. Not as much because Instagram won't let me go nude. So, you know the deal. But I'm still on there.
Yes.
Every 2 or 3 days under Mindbender Loves You. And I'm on Facebook too, Adam U. Stewart.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, Peppermint.
Yeah, you can find my shenanigans on Instagram at Randall Jordan. Mm-hmm. On Twitter, Jordan Randalls, MS. Facebook, of course, I have a website, jordanrandall.com. If you look up Peppermint on Bandcamp or SoundCloud, you find some beats. Mm. But just type in Jordan Randall and you'll find something, and that'll direct you to me, hopefully.
Okay.
But also, he has other projects too, and
yes, I just released an EP under my own name, Jordan Randall, that's like a folk EP. So you can find that on Spotify. Jordan Randall's called Quiet Plans, and I'm going to release a death metal album in the next couple months under the band name Demon Christ. So.
Okay.
We got a little...
Shouts out to Demon Christ there.
Yeah, okay. Straight up. Yeah, we have a little death metal in a very special song that we call Alien Orchestra on the album, and I genuinely believe it's the most advanced next level hip hop song of the year.
Okay.
Possibly on planet Earth, and I want to make some Kanye level, like college dropout era Kanye.
Yes, confident. Please.
College dropout era, like late registration, when there was a balance between the artistry and the ego, when one wasn't like way out of the stratosphere.
Okay.
We're still connected to reality. Yeah, but confident, like confidence in the art, mm-hmm. but also, you know, confidence, but also artistry. So we have the artistry.
All right. Well, yeah, we'll get into Kanye another time.
Yeah, for real.
Off the air. But you know what? I have a bone to pick with you, Mindbender.
Okay,
you know what it is?
Tell me.
And I know it's coming from an open and loving place.
Tell me.
But I just told you how I'm trying to squeeze into a dress for Thursday, and my man brings in like six delicious-looking cupcakes, and he has had them on... top of the board for this whole interview. And like he's waving his arms and the smell is coming to my nose.
I couldn't come in.
I like gifts though. I know.
No,
and you know what?
You had so much love.
I appreciate that. I appreciate that. I appreciate you always. Oh, Mindbender, the original staple in the maple, like I said. You can check out his new album. Follow him online. Follow his shenanigans all over online.
Yes.
And he's very open.
Yes, for
very,
real.
Very, very open.
Yo, Malcolm Lovejoy is ready to spread love. And Mindbender loves you too. Yo, we got this beautiful music, there's art, there's sexuality, but I also do relationship therapy. Like, it's not all sexual. Like, I also want to get to the point where people can just talk to me and just be like, yo, I'm going through troubles in my relationships, like, can I get advice? There's a dude in Ottawa who pays me $20 an hour to just be like, yo, I want to know
what,
like, I really, like, it's not just sex. Like, I really want to educate men on being better lovers.
Okay, child, we'll talk about that side hustle
my
off the air.
Here for that.
Yes, I'm here for that too. 20 bucks a car. We'll talk about this off the air. Talk about this off the air. All right, I'm going to turn it over to my people's DJ Channel 9. He has some music on deck. Keep it locked. Vibe 105. Call me up. 416-736-5656. We still have a pair of tickets to my anniversary party to give away going down this Thursday at Revival. So keep it locked right here, Studio B.